So welcome to the part 2 of the rope simulation video. In the last video we created this. We used physics Hooke's law to create a simulation of spring forces acting between two particles, and in this video we are going to expand on that to create a full rope which consists of number of particles. So the first thing we are going to create are two classes, one class called spring and another class called particles. The particle class represents the particles of our rope. It consists of various parameters like acceleration, position, the velocity and the mass of the object. And in the constructor we take in x and y, which will be the positions of our object, and then we use this value to initialize our light variables acceleration, position and velocity. And for the mass, for this assembly we are going to keep it as 1. So all our particles here will be unit mass. Then we create an update position method which will be responsible for updating position of our particles. We also need to create an update velocity method as well, which takes in x and y parameter, and we use that to update the velocity of our particles. Then we also create an update force method which takes in a vector force, and then we divide it by mass, and then we use it to calculate the acceleration of our particles. Create another method called update, which will be called every time we want to update the particles in the screen for simulating the rope. And here in this method we will be updating the velocity and use that velocity to update the position, and then we also update the acceleration. Here you might have noticed we are multiplying velocity by 0.99, which means there is a small damping action happening. Now coming to our spring class, here we define 4 members, particle A and B, and a spring constant of double K, and a rest length which is also double. And here also we need to create a new method called update, which will be taking care of updating the positions of the spring. Here we are using the same logic we used in our last video. So if you want to understand what this code does, basically this is Hooke's law implementation. You can watch my last video to understand this better. The only change here is that instead of using child and anchor, we are updating the particle A and the particle B. Now coming back to our widget class, we are going to copy the already existing one and create a new class called spring B. And here we are going to remove all the unnecessary code from the last video. We are however going to keep the update method and some late init variables like gravity, timer and rest length. The new additions here are our list of particles and list of springs, because in this case we have an n number of particles, and for that as well we have to create a new member called number of particles. And here we will be initializing everything inside the initState method, and here I am initially just creating particles with 0,0 position and the spring also with the same thing. This doesn't matter much because in the update method we will be updating them real time. And here I also do need to do another thing, because we have n number of particles, we do need to loop over them and add their positions individually. Here we are just using the I value of our for loop to space them in our canvas, and we are using this particle position to calculate the spring between them. And after initializing it, and inside of update method we have to update every time the timer changes, so we are looping over every items in the spring and updating the spring. As well as for the particles, we are calling the apply force and update method of all the particles to update their position whenever the time changes in the custom canvas. Now going to our custom painter which we created in the part 1 of this video, we are going to remove the existing members to the new particles and the springs list. Now coming back to our particle class, one thing we forgot to add was a member called fix, which is responsible for figuring out if a particle should not move or not. And in the constructor by default we are going to keep its value as false, and inside our update method We are going to add a boolean condition called if fix return, which means only update the position of a particles if it is not fixed. And now inside our initState method, we are going to say that the first and the last particles on our list will be fixed. Now inside our custom paint, I have cleaned all the code, and here we are going to define two variables called head and tail, which will be the first and the last particles of the list. And here we have defined few paint methods for painting the line and painting the circles. And here what we are going to do is loop through all the items in the particles and also draw a line between them. So we are going to make use of the path, and we have to set the initial position of our path to the first item of our particle, which is the head variable here. And inside our loop, we have already defined the current and the next particles as variables, and we are going to make use of their positions to draw a line between those two particles. And as a result, we will be drawing a line between all the particles in our item except the first and the last, which we have kept before. And now with the help of the draw path method of our canvas, we can pass in the path which we have created now and also the line paint. And when we hold restart, we can see that we have something going on in our canvas. Now this is not looking perfect. The first thing I want to do is I want to draw a circle, and I'm going to make use of the canvas draw circle method here. And the circle I'm drawing here is for the tail position, and I'm going to use this position to calculate the offset. And in hot restart, I can see the tail is not attached because I made a mistake inside the loop. I should be using the next particle position. And when I hot restart again, you can see that we have the ball or the tail part attached to the rest of the line here. And now this is not what we want, right? In a row, this is too straight. Now to draw something other than straight line, we have to draw a curve, and for this assembly we are going to make use of the QuadraticBezierCurve function of the canvas. And for the first thing we have to calculate is the midpoint, because a curve consists of midpoint and the curvature of the curve depends upon the position of the midpoint. And after calculating the midpoint here, which you can always, when you get this code, toggle between the value, we can use the values of the midpoint and the current position to draw the quadratic Bezier curve. We also made a mistake here. I should be, when I'm drawing the quadratic Bezier, I should be using the current position of the particle, so I shouldn't be using the next particle position. And when I hold restart again, now you can see that this curve or this rope is looking more like a rope. Now the next problem is that our rope is not attached. For that, we can make use of the line to method of the path. Right after our for loop, we have to draw another line which attaches from right where we end inside our for loop to the tail position. And that's where we have a connection between our rope and the tail. Now you can see that this is looking much more like a rope. Now since the very top and the very bottom position of a particle is fixed, let's also add a circle to the very top. Let's name it the head. Since we already have a head position defined, we are going to draw a circle with this position. Now you can see that we have some kind of rope animation here. And if you want to change the values we have defined before, like the rest length and the spacing, you can go up and change this value there to get different results. And all these particles, and you can see the changes in the row when you change the values you have defined here as well. Now the next thing we want to do is get rid of this interactive viewer, because we also want to add one more feature to this. So I'm going to make use of the GestureDetector, and inside our own update callback, I'm going to use the details which we get to calculate the current tap position. And using this current tap position, which is an offset, and also by selecting the very last particle of our particle list, which we want to drag over, we can update the position and as well as update the velocity, so that we will be able to drag the end of the rope. Now when we hot reset, you can see that we are able to drag the end of the rope, and as a result we have some kind of rope simulation happening as we drag as well. You can see all the kind of base a rope makes when you're moving one end of a rope as well. Now this simulation is not at all perfect, but this is the starting point, and now from this moment you can do your own customization on top of this. And as always, the code for this will be available in the GitHub. The link will be provided in the description as well. And if you want to see more videos like this with some cool Flutter animations or simulation, then do subscribe to my channel.